The Cunningham Panel is a series of tests developed to help physicians diagnose and treat the infection-triggered autoimmune disorders known as pediatric autoimmune neuropsychiatric disorder associated with streptococcal infection or PANDAS, and pediatric acute onset neuropsychiatric syndrome or PANS. PANDAS and PANS are clinical diagnoses that are based upon a patient's symptoms and medical history. When PANDAS or PANS is suspected, a physician can utilize the Cunningham Panel to aid and support their clinical diagnosis with laboratory evidence. The Cunningham Panel identifies antibodies associated with disorders such as PANDAS and PANS and their effects on neurologic behavior. PANDAS and PANS are autoimmune conditions that begin with a child's exposure to an infectious agent. The body launches an immune response against the infection, and certain children produce autoantibodies that not only fight the invading infection, but also attack the child's own healthy tissues. In PANDAS and PANS, autoantibodies are believed to attack neuronal targets or antigens within the brain, including the basal ganglia, a portion of the brain that is responsible for movement and behavior. The Cunningham Panel is comprised of five distinct tests. Four of these tests use enzyme-linked immunosorbent assays, or ELISAs, to measure the circulating levels of a patient's autoantibodies directed against four of the neuronal antigen targets: anti-dopamine receptor D1, anti-dopamine receptor D2L, anti-lysoganglioside, and anti-tubulin. Additionally, a fifth test measures the antibody-mediated activity of the enzyme calcium-dependent calmodulin protein kinase 2 or camkinase 2. Each of these autoimmune targets was chosen because of its correlation to symptoms of neuropsychiatric behavior that have been associated with synonym chorea, PANDAS, and PANS. Let's take a more in-depth look at the test's targets and how each affects neurologic function. Dopamine is a neurotransmitter, or a chemical manufactured in brain cells that is necessary for proper signal transmission within the brain. Dopamine receptors D1 and D2L are highly concentrated on neurons in the brain. During normal dopamine transmission, presynaptic or transmitting neurons produce and release dopamine, which then binds to dopamine receptors on postsynaptic or receiving neurons and initiates responses that affect neurologic processes such as fine motor control and cognition. In patients with PANDAS or PANS, autoantibodies may interfere with dopamine transmission by blocking the receptor activity or stimulating the receptor. This may lead to the sum of the neuropsychiatric symptoms associated with PANDAS and PANS, such as OCD and tics. Lysoganglioside GM1 is found within the membranes of nerve cells concentrated in the central nervous system. Lysoganglioside plays an important role in signal transmission in the brain and is vital for communication between neurons. Autoantibodies directed against lysoganglioside can interrupt this communication and interfere with normal neurologic activity. Tubulin is an intracellular scaffolding protein that is found in all cells, but is highly concentrated within the cells of the brain. Tubulin helps cells to maintain their shape and plays an important role in cell division. Anti-tubulin antibodies can interfere with these normal cellular functions within brain cells, leading to neurologic dysfunction. CAM kinase 2 is an enzyme that is highly abundant in the brain and is involved in increasing the levels of many neurotransmitters, including dopamine. The autoantibodies associated with PANDAS and PANS increase CAM kinase 2 activity, impacting neurotransmitter levels and affecting neuropsychiatric behavior. The Cunningham Panel report includes the results from each of the five tests. The four ELISA-involved tests measure the circulating levels of autoantibodies directed against four different antigen targets, and the results of these tests are expressed as titers, or final dilutions of each specific antibody. The fifth test is called the CAM kinase 2 activation test, and it measures the increase in activity of the CAM kinase 2 enzyme by the patient's serum when incubated with cultured human brain cells. The result of this test is represented as a percentage of CAM kinase 2 activity as compared to a baseline control. The results of each test are represented in the laboratory test results compared to normal ranges table, which includes the patient results, a normal range, and a normal mean for each test. Additionally, the patient results for each test are expressed on a colored scale below the table of results. The green color represents the values that fall within the normal range for each test, while the red color represents the values that fall outside of the normal range for each test. The collective results of the Cunningham Panel provide a current assessment of the autoimmune status of the patient at the time the blood sample was taken. It is important to remember that these are metabolic tests, which means that results can vary over time, with treatment, and with the presence or absence of symptoms. The discovery of additional autoimmune targets may help better identify and define PANDAS and PANS patients and their symptoms. Moleculera Labs maintains a commitment to help physicians in their diagnosis of PANDAS and PANS through ongoing research and development of test markers. The Cunningham Panel is the first and only laboratory test available to aid clinicians in their diagnosis of PANDAS and PANS patients.